Hey guys, so today I have to go to work, so I figured let's just film my full face, and that's pretty much all I have to say, so let's just get into it. I'm gonna start off real quick with the Benefit Brow-Vo Brow Primer. This just kind of conditions your brows and primes them for makeup, make your brows last longer, and also kind of helps them grow a little bit, grow a little thicker. I'm gonna prime my eyes with the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. And then just setting that with some translucent powder. My brushes are so dirty and I really need to wash them, but I'm just so lazy. I'm gonna take Burnt Orange by Anastasia on a Sigma E35 and I'm just gonna start that in my crease. Ooh, maybe I wanna do a halo eye. I'm gonna take a little bit of orange soda. Orange soda has become like one of my favorite eyeshadows. I use it in pretty much every tutorial, I feel like. It's really amazing. Highly recommend you get it. It just helps blend everything out, especially for my skin tone. I don't know, it's just perfect. I'm gonna go all the way from inner corner to outer corner and make it even. Like, you don't want the outer corner to be darker or the inner corner darker. You want it to be just evenly distributed throughout the eyeball. On E34, I'm gonna take Brick, which is one of her new eyeshadows, and I'm gonna place this on the outer corner and inner corner of the eye. I'm gonna go back with my E35 and just blend it out a tiny bit. Now I'm gonna take this guy in Rose Gold Retro. I'm just gonna put that on the center of my lid where it's blank right now. I'm gonna use my pinky to tap it out. It's so pretty. Every time I use these, I'm just obsessed. It's so easy to use and it looks amazing in like 2 seconds. What more could you want from an eyeshadow? Go catch up the other eye real quick and I'll be right back. Now I'm gonna just do a little bit of eyeliner using the Sigma Wicked Gel Eyeliner and an E75. Sometimes I forget how much I love this eyeliner. It's just so dark and so black. Perfect. Let's do the face. As you can see, my face is breaking out. Yay for periods! I'm gonna take the Hourglass Veil Mineral Primer, putting that all over my face. So I'm gonna take the Cover FX, the highlighting drops in the shade Sunlight, and you wanna shake these up. I'm just gonna take a drop onto my sponge. This is the Sigma 3D HD sponge, by the way. And I'm gonna put it on my cheekbone. Since these highlights are so pigmented, I put it underneath my foundation so you can still see it kind of beaming from underneath, you know? Just so gorgeous. I went to a training on Cover FX yesterday, actually, and I learned a lot of cool stuff. So with these drops, you could either like mix it with your foundation or do what I'm doing or put it on top, or really you could do whatever you want with it. This is just how I like to use it. I find if I mix it with my foundation, I don't really see the glow. But if I do it this way, then I do see the glow. Now to cover up my little red spots here, I'm gonna take the Kevin Kwan Sensual Skin Enhancer. This is in the shade SX09. So Kevin Kwan actually sent this to me, but it's too dark, but I can still make it work if I put it underneath my foundation. It is so high coverage, it covers up any little blemish. I kinda wanna buy it in my real shade so I can use it like properly, but I mean, it's amazing. So you only take like one dot. Like, there's nothing on my finger. And you can just cover up any little blemishes. I'm gonna take my sponge and just blend that in. Obviously, I don't have a fake tan on my face right now, but this is like too pinky for what I want to be, but it's amazing, so I make it work. For my foundation, I'm gonna take the MAC Next to Nothing foundation in the shade Medium, and then I'm gonna mix it with the Cover FX Custom Drops in the shade G30. So these guys wanna shake as well. what I learned that these are 98% pigment, which is a lot. And you're supposed to mix it with something. If you put the Street on your face, you're gonna look crazy. So that's why I mix it with this foundation, because this one is so lightweight. This one's high pigment, so you put it together and it's like a lightweight, high pigment foundation, you know? I don't know why I get so excited over it, but that's fine. A few drops of this bad boy. Oop. Four drops maybe. And put it on my face. Just using my sponge and blending it in. So with these drops, you can mix it with a primer, mix it with a face serum, with moisturizer, mix it with another foundation like I did. It's incredible though. I really want to try mixing it with the Too Faced Hangover Primer. I have one sitting somewhere, but I feel like I would really like that because I'm obsessed with that primer. It would give me a nice coverage, you know? I don't usually get to go to these trainings at work a lot, just because at my store I'm an operation manager. I don't really work in the makeup section, you know? I prefer to do operations, but I love to learn about makeup and do my makeup. I'm gonna take some Fix Plus and I'm just gonna spray that on my face just to bring back a little hydration. Feeling a little dry right now. I'm gonna take some Shape Tape and Fair Beige. You will always see me drag my concealer out here to kind of shape my eyeshadow to give it that nice kind of line and like a cat eye shape. I'm just gonna take some translucent powder. This is the RCMA one, just in a different container. And I'm just gonna set under my eyes. I'm gonna do a little bit of cream contour, so I'm gonna take the Allure Mercier cream contour kit. And on F79, I'm gonna mix all three shades here. And I'm just gonna start to contour. And then take my sponge and just tap over it. I always pat over everything with my sponge so it just looks all seamless and blended in, you know? I'm gonna set my cheek contour with the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette and a Sigma F05. Oh, and I'm taking the middle shade, by the way. I'm gonna mix the three lighter shades on my F35. I'm gonna go right under my contour. I'm gonna go do my brows off camera and I'll be right back. I'm gonna take the MAC Mineralized Blush in Warm Soul on a Sigma F10. Over with my sponge, per usual. I'm gonna do a soft highlight on my face. I know, who am I? I got this yesterday. This is the Cover FX highlighter in Sunlight, so it's the same color as the drops I used. And let's try this out. I'm using a Sigma F64. Not usually a soft highlighter person. My skin is really, my skin has a lot of texture right now. Probably best if I do not do a crazy highlight. We don't want to really accentuate the texture. Not as golden as I want it. It's looking a little too white on my skin. I'm gonna go over it with some Champagne Pop. I just gotta finish up the eyes and we are almost done. The best part about filming is being done with filming. That sounds so bad. No, I love filming, but you know. A lot of work. I'm gonna go back in with Brick on my E34 and I'm just gonna put that all under my eye. taking some orange soda to blend it out. I'm gonna do some mascara and lashes, and I'll be right back. So for lashes, I used my new favorite lashes right now. They are by Luxie Lash, and they're the style called Litty Committee. They are so cute. They're just fluffy, and they taper out towards the ends, which is my favorite eyelash shape. I'm obsessed with these. They are beautiful. I do have a coupon code with them. It's just Angela for, I think it's like 20% off, which is amazing. But Luxie Lash has some of my favorite eyelashes ever, and they are so kind to me, and I just love them so much. And then for lips, you guys should already know that I am not a lipstick person. I hate lipstick. I don't like it. So I just threw on the Buxom White Russian Full-On Lip Cream. I wear this with any look if I can. I'm always wearing a nude. I will not wear a color. I will usually wear this or just like a nude colored gloss. That's just what I do. I hate lipstick. I can't do it, man. But yeah, here is my final makeup look, and I love it. The eyeshadow is super easy. We need setting spray. Urban Decay All Nighter. Yes. Okay. Let me know if you like the full face videos. I know some people really like just the eye makeup tutorials. Some people really want the full face videos. My full face videos get the most thumbs down. I'm like, do you not like my face? Like, okay, whatever, but I mean. But if you prefer just eye makeup tutorials, let me know. Because those are pretty easy for me to film and do on a regular basis compared to like these full face looks. Because I only wear full face makeup like once a week really, so. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.